New hero! Overwatch's newest hero is Baptiste, and he's from the Caribbean, Haiti to be exact. And he's a combat medic, so you can heal and do decent damage to enemies. I'm Grasshopper, and I made this guide so you can learn how to play Baptiste. Let's get into it. Baptiste is a support hero. He has medium power, 200 health, medium mobility, and then according to Overwatch, he's a 3-star hero, which means he's hard difficulty to use. Baptiste's weapon is his biotic launcher. It has 2 firing modes. Primary fire is a hitscan 3-round burst with modest damage but heavy recoil. And the secondary fire is a grenade launcher that heals nearby allies on impact. Reloading will replenish ammo for both firing modes. Let's go over the damage firing mode first. Since the primary fire is a burst, the crosshair will recoil up as you fire, so be aware to pull down to stay accurate. The damage is 50 per bullet up to 20 meters away, with damage falling off to 25 per bullet past 40 meters. So hitting all bullets in a burst will do 75 to 150 damage, depending on the range. You can shoot about 2 bursts per second or 6 bullets, so the DPS is about 150 to 300 if you hit every bullet, which can be hard. The realistic DPS is probably around 160 if you miss a few shots and are at medium range. Aiming for headshots is a good idea, so you can do more damage per bullet. There's 45 ammo, or 15 shots in a magazine, and the reload takes 1.5 seconds. So Baptiste can have decent damage output, but make sure to heal your team first. Speaking of his healing, let's go over his secondary fire. The healing projectiles are similar to Junkrat's grenades in how they arc through the air and explode on the ground, but they only heal teammates. The healing will not affect Baptiste himself, and the projectiles will fly through full health teammates, like Ana's darts. The radius of the healing is 3 meters, so it's not too difficult to splash an injured teammate, and the healing is 60 health per projectile. The fire rate is about 1 shot per second, and the reload speed is quicker when constantly firing at 0.95 seconds. So this just means if you still have ammo in his primary fire, and you empty all the heal grenades out, the reload will be a little bit faster, so you can get those heal grenades back quicker, which is nice. But the average reload will still take anywhere from a second to 1.5 seconds. The healing from the biotic launcher isn't as high as Ana, but it is higher than Lucio, and there's ways to increase it as well. It's also not Baptiste's only way to heal his team. Finally, you are able to shoot both firing modes at the same time if you wanted to, and remember, reloading will replenish ammo in both modes. Here are Baptiste's abilities on your screen now. His ultimate is Amplification Matrix, which is used with Q or Y on Xbox. Baptiste creates a matrix that doubles the damage and healing effects of friendly projectiles that pass through it. It can be placed like a Maywall, so you can rotate it before placing it, and firing through either side will give the amplified effects. The matrix is only 5 meters wide, so it's smaller than a Reinhardt barrier, but it can be placed up to 35 meters away. The matrix lasts for 8 seconds and will amplify all damage and most healing effects that pass through it by 100%. To put that into perspective, a Reinhardt Firestrike will do 200 damage through this, so he can snipe people. It's awesome, actually, but this ultimate is very situational and can swing a fight in your favor. Ana healing will be 160 per shot if she shoots through the matrix, but Moira's biotic orb total damage or healing isn't doubled. What is changed is the speed at which the healing or damage is done from that orb, which that is doubled. Other damage boosts like Mercy's Beam, Supercharger, and Nano Boost will be added to the 100% amplification, so with Mercy Damage Beam, the total damage is 230% increase. This allows Widowmaker to one-shot Roadhog with a headshot. The amplification matrix can be destroyed by EMP, but that's the only counterplay to it. Depending on where you put it, you can amplify the damage or healing your team can do. I recommend putting the matrix right behind your tanks, so healing that hits them will be doubled, and ranged DPS can shoot through the matrix as well while being protected by the tanks in front. Dancing back and forth through the matrix should allow any damage or healing shot from you to be doubled as long as you shoot through it. Positioning and surprise is key for the matrix to be effective. I would use it to swing a fight, so put it down as the enemy pushes in, especially when they push in on your backline. Baptiste's first ability is Regenerative Burst. This is used with Shift or Left Bumper on Xbox. Baptiste activates a regenerative burst of healing for himself and allies nearby over time. The healing burst is applied immediately, so allies that leave the radius will still be healed over time, but allies that enter the radius after the effect was applied won't get any healing. The radius of effect is 10 meters, which is slightly smaller than Lucio's healing aura. The healing is 30 per second over 5 seconds for 150 total healing, and the cooldown is 15 seconds. This is Baptiste's burst healing ability, and in conjunction with his healing grenades, he can bring teammates back up to full health. This is also the only way Baptiste can heal himself, so don't waste the ability, and wait for when a lot of damage comes in from the enemies. Try to group up with most of your team, or tell them to come closer before activating the regenerative burst, so everyone gets the heal over time. It's not like Brigitte's Inspire passive heal, which will just heal like a flat amount over time. This activates immediately and puts on an effect on your team to heal them over time. It won't heal them up after they walk in after the burst. I'd wait to use this until after the immortality field, because it's better to be unkillable than just heal a little. Speaking of immortality, Baptiste's next ability is Immortality Field. This is used with E, or right bumper, on Xbox. Baptiste deploys a device that creates an area which prevents allies from dying. The device can be destroyed by enemy damage or a hack from Sombra. The drone device has 250 health and lasts for 8 seconds, then goes on cooldown for 20 seconds. The Field of Immortality has a radius of 6 meters from the drone and prevents allies' health from going below 20%. Squishy heroes will have at least 20 health, and a tank like Reinhardt will have 100 health. The drone can be bounced off walls and has the same trajectory as Baptiste's health grenade, which gives you an idea of where it can be launched. It also cannot be eaten by defense matrix, deflected by Genji, or blocked by enemy barriers. In order to kill heroes inside the immortality field, you'll need to destroy the drone first. If an attack destroys the drone and damages heroes in the field at the same time, they will not die, but they'll be lowered to 20% of their health, so they're super weak. For example, if an enemy diva bomb explodes inside the immortality field, it will destroy the drone and knock back the heroes away from the blast, but they will still be alive with 20% of their health. The immortality field is a really strong ability and should be saved for key moments like when enemies use their ultimates. When I first saw the Baptiste reveal, I thought this ability would be his ultimate because it's so powerful. You can keep your team from dying to a Genji Blade, Diva Bomb, Grab Dragon Strike combo, Riptire, and many other high damage attacks as long as your team stays in the area of effect and is not destroyed. Soldier's Tac Visor and Fair's Barrage are still sort of strong because they both can destroy the drone and then kill your team, but the immortality field can buy you some time to take out the threat. There's so many different ways to use the immortality field, and many more we haven't learned yet, so I can't wait until Baptiste is in competitive play. I'll go over the immortality field more in the how to use section near the end of this video. Baptiste has a passive ability, which are his exo boots. So by crouching first, Baptiste can jump higher. Holding crouch will charge a meter that determines how high you can jump afterwards. It takes 1 second to fully charge the boots. After releasing crouch, the boots will stay charged for 1 second to allow you to jump, otherwise they'll reset. This ability cannot be stopped by a Sombra hack or EMP since it's a passive. This ability enables Baptiste to reach the high ground easily so he can fire his heal grenades into his team from above or escape the enemies. Exoboots could also be used to avoid enemy abilities if timed correctly, like Roadhog's Hook or maybe Reinhardt's Earth Shatter. Let's move on to Baptiste's counters. Since Baptiste is a healer, your main focus is to keep your team alive, but with Baptiste using a hitscan weapon and him being able to reach the high ground easily, he can be effective at dealing damage as well. Baptiste is strong against Pharah, Junkrat, Doomfist, Mei, Roadhog, Zarya, another Baptiste, and sometimes Genji, Reaper, Winston, D.Va, and Reinhardt. Baptiste is weak to any amount of focus fire, whether it's at range or up in his face, so try not to venture off by yourself. Specifically, Baptiste is countered by Sombra, Hanzo, Widowmaker, Soldier 76, Tracer, and sometimes Wrecking Ball, Genji, and Orisa. The counters to Baptiste could change over time, so we might be talking about harder counters later on, but Sombra is definitely the best hero against Baptiste. Let's move on to the how to use Baptiste. So Baptiste is an aggressive healer with a lot of strong tech to help his team. First of all, remember to prioritize healing your allies over doing damage because you'll need them, and that's your role as a healer. When you do get the chance, you can try to take out an enemy that's out of position because his damage output is pretty strong, but be sure to watch your teammates' health. Use the Exo Boots crouch jump to reach the high ground where you can easily lob healing grenades into your team, and it makes shooting enemies easier as well. The Exo Boots can also save you from certain enemy abilities, so it's a good idea to charge them up when you can. With the amount of ammo in his biotic launcher, Baptiste doesn't need to reload much, only when he's low on the heal grenades, so remember that. Use the regenerative burst ability when you get critically low on health, or when most of your team is low on health and close to you. You don't want to waste this powerful heal over time, since the cooldown is 15 seconds. Using regenerative bursts and shooting a heal grenade at a tank about 5 times should bring them back up almost full health in a short amount of time. But use the immortality field before the regenerative burst if the enemy team dives in aggressively. That'll stop you from dying, and then you can heal up afterwards. The immortality field is Baptiste's most game-changing ability, so practice using it a lot and learn when you need it and when you don't. It has a very long cooldown at 20 seconds, so it can't be wasted on damage that you could have healed instead. I recommend using it only to counter enemy ultimates so your team doesn't die, or using it on an ally that overextended or is cut out so your team can potentially go and save them. The immortality field can be thrown out pretty far and bounced off walls, so keep this in mind. If you want to use it on yourself, you have to look almost straight down first. Another use for the immortality field is protecting a static team comp like Pirate Ship from an enemy dive that attempts to kill your carry teammate. Imagine a Bastion that literally cannot die and keeps pumping damage out. This might be the meta we're moving into, so practice your Sombra as she is the best counter to Baptiste and his immortality drone, as well as a Bastion. Finally, let's go over the ultimate, Amplification Matrix. It's another situational ability for Baptiste, so it'll take some time to know when and where to use it correctly. You know it doubles your team's damage and healing that goes through it, so if you can put it in a spot where the majority of your team can shoot through it at the enemies, it'll be a good use. I recommend putting it directly behind your tanks because they don't necessarily do a lot of damage, and any healing put on them will be doubled. Your DPS teammates can also shoot through the matrix like your healers, and if the enemy team pushes you, you can drop the immortality field right on top of you and pop heals on your team, as well as do damage. Baptiste is a fast-paced healer with interesting abilities that makes playing Overwatch fun again, and should break the meta as we know it. Go play Baptiste right now, and more importantly, play with one, because there's so many team comps you can create. Baptiste can also do a lot of damage with his gun, if you're accurate, but only do this when you don't need to heal, so he could also work as the flex DPS role in a comp with at least two other healers. But that's it for the overview on Baptiste. I hope you all enjoyed it and learned something. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe. Also, I want to invite you to watch me stream, since it's always so much fun, and you can learn a lot about Overwatch while I play. I stream on Twitch, Mixer, and here on YouTube, so give me a follow or hit that bell icon to get notified when I go live. As always, I'm Grasshopper. Keep hopping.